Hey guys, this is the airbike by Busman. Look at how small this hover bike is. Alright, I'm gonna give you guys a quick walk around here. So the airbike only cost 379 PCO with 32 blocks. That's a really, really low PC even for my standard. Alright, let's see here. The bike is using the new flat thrusters, that's why it's able to be this compact here. The bike also used the neon tube blocks here for the landing gears. That's a really PCU efficient way of doing it. The bike does have actual magnetic plates down here though, so you know, this can actually land on stuff and carry stuff as well. I like how the bike is using the neon paint job for the lights of the bike and stuff. That's a very creative and efficient way of doing it. What the hell? We got two small warfare reactors to the back of the bike here. That's definitely not necessary for the amount of thrusters that the bike is using, but it does look really cool. This hover bike doesn't have any backward thruster. What the hell? Maybe it doesn't need one because it's a racing bike or something. To the back of the vehicle. We actually get a license plate here and a single gyroscope there. I do like these canards as well. But yeah, well, that's pretty much the whole exterior. Let's ride the bike now. The upward acceleration of the vehicle is not really that amazing actually. The forward acceleration. Well, I guess it's not really meant to be a racing bike then. I'm guessing this is more like an efficient hover bike or something. And I'm guessing we cannot really tilt forward. Yeah, you probably shouldn't be pitching forward on this vehicle. This is not gonna go well at all. Alright, let's see how well this vehicle can go downhill. Turn off the power. Well, yeah, the vehicle just pretty much disintegrate the moment it impacts the hill there. What a tragedy. Can we even carry weapons on this thing though? I guess we can put like a single turret here, right? This should be fine. There you go. Alright, let's see how well this vehicle can deal with an enemy base. I'm gonna try to use the terrain to our advantage here. Come on. We're actually really maneuverable. I mean, we're not really that maneuverable, but we're like super small, so it's kind of hard for the enemy turrets to... hold on. What the hell? Wait, what? Did we actually... hold on, we're falling. We barely have enough thrust. Hold on though, did we actually destroy all the enemy turrets? I mean, I'm pretty sure the artillery turret is still functioning. But I guess if we try... No. Hold on. Hold on. Well, that was kind of surprising though. We're actually able to disable two of the three enemy turrets. But well, as you guys can see there, the biggest enemy of this vehicle is the lack of performance. But yeah, well, I was actually expecting more performance from this vehicle. I mean, for the PCU, you do get a nice looking vehicle with this vehicle. The creator did a really good job with the aesthetic of the vehicle considering the limitations and the PCU. But you know, the performance is really, really lacking on this vehicle. Not having any reverse thruster is also very inconvenient. I feel like they can, you know, maybe put one or two reverse thrusters like this ones, and that will make this vehicle a lot more convenient to fly. But well, I guess if you like the look of the vehicle and you just want a small and fun vehicle to like zip around, then this can be a good vehicle. Say, this is the airbike by Busman. You guys can find the link in the description below. Sorry if there's like a lot of jump cuts in this video, by the way. I still cannot speak properly. Mm.